pork tenderloin.
Sure, how many?
Just one. They say opposites attract, but perhaps there's no odder combination than the sweetness of fruit paired with the savory depth of meat. You know, it seems like it wouldn't work, but it really does.
Take my pork tenderloin. I grill it and then dress it with a cantaloupe and cucumber salsa. Crunchy, sweet, and sour, it plays off the pork perfectly for the ultimate easy summertime meal. On Ask Sara, I'll answer a viewer's questions about lemons and how to get the most out of them. And then my son Sam will join me for a simple sauteed chicken, one of his favorites, that perks right up with the addition of lemon and capers. Another fruit and meat combo you are going to love.
Fruit and meat, it's not weird, it's really good. I'm going to show you next on Sara's Weeknight Meals. Thank you.
Funding provided by
the 2016 Subaru Legacy. With symmetrical all-wheel drive plus 36 mpg. It pairs well with every kind of road. Subaru, proud sponsor of Sara's Weeknight Meals.
And thanks to the generous support of
this is the perfect summer meal on a plate. Grilled pork tenderloin on top of a salsa made of cucumber, cantaloupe, fresh herbs, red onion, and then topped off with a creamy feta dressing that's been lightened up by buttermilk. It's also very quick to make. I'm going to reach for a machine today to make it even faster. So I'm going to start by getting my red onions soaked because I love onions. I don't mind eating them raw, but they have, you know, they have that oniony flavor, that bite. How you tone that down is by soaking them in ice water. So I'm going to just slice up about a half a cup of an onion and put it in some ice water. Now I made this mistake years ago and I blanched a whole bunch of peas and I threw them into ice water and the ice cubes were very tiny and the peas were very tiny and I threw them into the ice water loose. I spent the rest of the show fishing out a pea from every ice cube. So I got smart. You put your onion in a strainer and then put it in the ice water so that you can fish it out easily. Paper thin, make it small. That's good. Maybe give another one little chop here and there just so that you don't get big, big chunks of onion. All right, so that's gonna soak for about 20 minutes. And I'm just gonna park this over here. And now I'm going to make this creamy dressing. We do have some cheese. This is 2 ounces of crumbled feta cheese. I'm going to add 1/3 cup of the buttermilk, 1/4 cup of mayonnaise, 1 tablespoon each of fresh lemon juice and olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. And I'm going to puree it till it's really smooth and creamy. Wonderfully creamy. Let's have a look. Isn't that fun? You just turn it right side around and there it is. Oh, that looks perfect. Wow. Let me just show you on a spoon. Hang on. How creamy it is. How beautifully pureed. You see that? Isn't that lovely? There we go. But we want a few chunks of the cheese in there too, so I'm just gonna stir the second 2 ounces in. Okay, so that's our dressing. You know, it's funny, because when I was first a chef, I did everything by hand, you know. How dare you use a machine? But now, I love my machines. They make life a lot easier, especially when you're trying to get dinner on the table like that. Okay, it's time for the pork tenderloin. I love pork tenderloin because it's lean, and yet, unlike its cousin, you know, or its neighbor, pork loin, they lie in the same place next to each other in the animal. The difference between the two is this is very tender. It's like beef tenderloin. So, and it doesn't tend to dry out as much as pork loin, which is also very lean. They're the two leanest cuts. So I always reach for this over the pork loin, which is bigger, got a bigger eye, but just not my favorite. So I am oiling the pork tenderloin. When you're grilling, I've learned this from my friend Elizabeth Carmel, who's been on this show, that you oil the item. You don't oil the grill, because everybody else tells you to oil the grill, and that's wrong. It makes the grill tacky and have buildup and get sticky. Whereas when you oil the food, as long as the grill is hot, it won't stick. Okay, we'll do the other side, and then we're going to just take this out. There we go. And just salt and pepper. You could add more spices if you want. Now, we're going to grill this. I've been preheating the grill, and we're going to do it on medium. And it's when you think about a pork tenderloin, even though it's round, there's like four sides, if you think of it that way. So we're going to do about 2 minutes a side, so all of it gets nicely colored. And then we'll check its temperature. It should be at about 140. And then we'll let it rest so all the juices redistribute. Okay, I think we're ready to go. I'm gonna go out and put this on the grill. Okay. And while that rests, I'm going to get my salsa together. I've got a little bit here. I'm going to cut another piece. We need 1.5 cups chunked cantaloupe. Removing the skin. You want these to be uniform chunks because we're going to chop it quickly in this machine. There we go. So there's our melon. Now we're using one of those seedless cucumbers. I think it's so funny they say these are seedless. Yeah, they have seeds, but they're completely edible. We want less of the cucumber, more of the melon. Okay, so melon goes in first. Cucumber, because it's softer, you want to put the harder fruit in first. And we're just going to pulse it a few times. All right, that might be it, just two pulses. Nice colors, isn't it? You should smell it too. Now, this gets our onions, which have had their time to lose their pungency. Oh, I think that's a little more onion than I want. I mean, I give amounts, it's like anything else. You can decide how much you want of everything, but I don't think I'll put quite all these onions in there. Okay, very pretty. And now we're gonna add a little fresh lime juice. Here we have some salt, a little bit of salt, and I'm just gonna quick toss this up with my impeccably clean hands. And then add our herbs. Oh, that is so pretty, isn't it? So here I have some mint. This is about 3/4 cup of mint leaves. And if you've never used herbs in a salad, you should use them like you use lettuce. They are just delicious. Don't just use them for a garnish at the end. Now I'm going to do something a tad lazy. I could pick off, you know, one at a time the pieces of cilantro, but instead I'm just going to give this a quick haircut, which will knock off some pieces. There we go, that looks nice. All right. Okay, let's say that was about 3/4 cup. All right, now this is the base, and then I'm gonna slice my pork, and then it goes on top with our dressing. Okay, let me put this on there, and then I'm gonna get my pork. So I'll put a nice mound. And don't forget the salt. The salt is important. Okay. I'm going to show you all, see here, I'll take my pork off. See all this juice that was left? I'm going to add that right to our sauce. We are doing what Madeline Kamen, a great cooking teacher and chef from Boston, used to say. We are marrying the meat to the sauce, because up until now there was no relationship. Just stir that in. There we go. Just take it right from the middle. Nicely, see the nice little pink glow there?
you could, I mean, depending on how large your pork tenderloin is, you can get 3 to 4 portions out of one, because it's a pound, and the idea being is to keep it to about 4 ounces per person. Okay, and then we're just gonna drizzle our sauce on top. See how creamy that is? So there you have it, my grilled pork tenderloin on a cucumber and cantaloupe salsa with a creamy feta dressing. Perfect for a hot summer night. I get so many great questions on my website. I just love answering them. And I have one today for Ask Sara from Dave in Littleton, Colorado. Hey, Dave. I understand you have some interest in lemons.
Yeah, I do. We use a lot of lemons in my cooking. And I was wondering how to get the most juice out of them, because we just go through lemons.
Right, right. And that's a good point. You really want to get the most juice. So for starts, when you go pick a lemon, you go to the store, you should feel them. And what you're looking for is a lemon that has good give, meaning you, when you press it, your fingers go in. If your fingers don't go in, that means it has a thicker outside and less of an inside, which is where all the juice is. So for starts, get the right lemon. So then another trick I like to do is, and this is true whether it's a lemon or a lime, is to take the citrus and lean on it with both of your hands, bruise it a bit.
Oh.
And that helps to soften up the inside. However, if you have a microwave, do you have a microwave?
Oh, yes, I love my microwave. I thought you didn't like them, though.
Well, you know what? I finally broke down and bought one so I could heat coffee. But I use it for a few other things. Like I nuke lemons for 20 seconds. If you do more than one, you need to nuke it longer than 20 seconds. But I want to show you how juicy this is when I cut it open. This has been nuked for 20 seconds because it really helps to get the juices going. Use a serrated knife for, I don't know if you can see how wet it is. See, there's even some on the counter already.
Oh,
and
yeah.
This is especially, I knew these had a big outside, a big pith when I felt them. You want the thinner skinned lemons if you can get them. Then I have several favorite tools. This is one, it's a good old fashioned Mexican reamer. They've got different sizes for the lemon and for the lime. And this works very nicely. I'm just gonna put this little guy in here. You put it cut side down. Not curved side down, cut side down, and that's because all the holes where the juice come out are right there. It's sort of counterintuitive because you want to put it the other way, but this is the way it goes.
Oh, I always put them in upside down.
Yeah, isn't that interesting? So now we go, and I like this because you can get both hands involved and just squish it. Okay.
Now, that makes so much more sense.
Doesn't it? Now here's another trick I learned from Jasper White, told to me by Ming Tsai, now I'm dropping names, which is use your tongs as a lemon juicer. So what you do is you just put them right in there and then just squeeze. Isn't that fantastic? Now here's
I never thought of that.
Yeah, I love this tool. It's good for so many things. Then what you can use the leftover lemon for is to clean your cutting board, clean your hands. Actually, I don't know if you have any copper, but if you did, like a copper bowl or copper, you take lemon and salt. You can just put some salt on it, kosher salt, rub it on the copper. It will clean it beautifully. And finally, if you have a disposal, you can put these down the disposal and they'll make it smell nice and fresh. All right. Well, so I hope you do some of these little things I've shown you.
I just learned how to use a squeezer.
There you go. I know. Put it in the right way. Thank you so much for your question, and I hope you keep on cooking. I'm glad you cook for your wife. We need more of that. If you want to send me a question, please do to saramoulton.com. We would love to take your questions, and I will answer them on Ask Sara.
Sauté is the name of the game today. And we are making a wonderful lemon chicken dish. And I happen to be cooking with one of my favorite sous chefs and my best testers, my son, Sam. Are you up for this?
Yes, Ma. I'm very up for this.
Well, we're making lemon chicken, and we have to start by pounding the meat. So let's do that first. And let me just say one tip that he already knows is when you're pounding chicken, you need to put a little water on the plastic so that the chicken doesn't rip. You know, otherwise it ends up looking like Lay's.
Yes.
Okay, ready?
Pound
one,
away.
Two, three.
Pound away!
All right, before we get too lacy.
Yeah, before it's...
You need a little more in there.
All right, yes,
just in the middle. Wow, that's big. Okay, so the reason that we want to pound it, okay, let's put away the weapons.
Put away the weapons.
Is so let's cut, you want to cut each of these in half this way, and then we'll park them and hose down.
Sounds good.
Okay, oops, we can lose the top piece, yeah. The reason we're pounding them is because then they take a lot less time to cook. And what do we like most in the house? We like the meat or do we like the sauce?
Sauce.
Yeah. So the thinner the meat, the more sauce you get on each piece, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
More surface area.
Oh, you cut. That's good enough.
Did
I do that?
You beat it until it ripped in half, ma'am.
I did. Okay. So that's the chicken. We're going to move on to the capers. And so I'm clean, you're all dirty, you can hose down.
Yes, Ma.
But cut that in half first.
Hose down or cut things, Ma, come on.
I know, I'm being bossy as usual. So, there's capers, they're the pickled bud of a Mediterranean flower.
Wow, sort fancy.
Sort of fancy. I want to know who was the first person who walked past that bud and said, gee, I'm going to pickle that. You know, you can't eat raw, I don't know why they thought of that. But at any rate, I need about 2 tablespoons. If you put them in a hot pan, they sort of explode, because they're wet. Now that would not be much fun now, would it?
No.
So I'm gonna pat this dry. You wanna put some oil in there.
Yes.
A couple tablespoons.
Okay.
And we're gonna put this in a cold pan. We dry them so they don't pop, and we start them in a cold pan so we don't wear them. So we're gonna start with those guys.
All right, so now can I turn on the heat?
Yes, you can. It's the left one right here.
Okay.
Okay. Medium heat.
All right.
And you can keep an eye on them, and we'll stir them, and I'm gonna season the chicken. And while it's happening, I'm going to tell you that when I started on TV many, many years ago, of course when I was just 12, well that's not possible because Sammy was 5. But at any rate, Sammy was on the show a lot. What do you remember?
Yeah, I remember when I thought I was a comedian and thought I was quite funny, and I remember trying to get a joke across. I was obsessed with the meatball crossing the street joke. Of course, the family favorite.
You made it up.
Yeah, I did.
You made it up. Are you kidding?
Well, yeah.
You popped it on me. That was the first. Do you remember how it went?
Something like, why'd the meatball try and cross the road to get to the field of spaghetti?
You're not supposed to give the punchline that quickly.
To
the field of spaghetti.
Okay, I'm sorry.
But anyway, what happened was, so Sammy said, you know, he's down here. He's like, Mom, I want to tell a joke. And my producer, who's in my ear in the control room, is like, no. And the good news about live TV, it was live TV, is you can do anything you want. So I said, go ahead, Sam. What do you want to tell me? And at any rate, then he told his very silly joke, and it was a lot of fun, right?
Oh, it was a great time. That was a lot of fun. The other instance that I remember was when you had the New York Giants on. And I was too young to know how cool they were and all this stuff.
I think those guys had to do the show sitting down with me.
Yeah, what? You would have to have a step stool for your mouth or something.
Right. All right, so when those are going to get a little bit crispy, and what you're going to do is actually put them right back on this dish with the slotted spoon. But wait till they look a little crispy. And meanwhile, I'm going to flour the chicken. So this is instantized flour, which is gravy flour, but it also really gives a nice crust on the outside of the chicken. And we're just browning these on both sides.
Yeah.
And then they only take a few minutes. And I'm going to go get the lemon and the shallots.
Looks great.
Yeah. So you keep an eyeball on this.
Well, you taught me not to touch them so they get nice and brown. So I'm going to give them a second and give them some air time.
Right. So let me get our lemon and shallot. And you can slice it very thin, okay? And I'm going to see how we're doing. Yeah, that looks good. We don't want too much color on this.
True, that looks great.
That looks yummy.
I just want a little more brown, get it tan, not burnt.
Okay, and a little nubbin for you.
Yes, the tasting nubbin.
Yeah, the tasty one. Okay, so now I'm gonna chop up some shallot. real quickly go grab a plate of sugar. I need about 2 tablespoons.
Okay, ma'am.
And I'm just going to get this shallot done.
Okay.
Now, the reason we're using shallots, I love shallots. It's very French, again. It's because they're really sweet, and they give a great depth of flavor. They get brown in the sauce. I think those guys can come out.
Yes. Can I have the tongs, please?
Yes. Okay, so here we go.
There we go.
So this is going to go in. There we go.
And at this part is where I want to kind of scrape up all the brown stuff.
Yeah. This will be very quick. And you know what? Then we're going to just dump the shallots in with the capers.
Okay.
So those are beautifully browned.
Yeah, quick.
This is all going to come together afterwards. So we're going to have the salty capers and the acidic lemons and the wonderful sauce from the chicken.
Nice.
And it's sort of like a take on piccata. Have you ever had? I don't use fancy names at home. Okay,
no,
back on with more.
Oil?
A little more oil, about a tablespoon.
Okay.
And then we can do this together because I want to get it on.
Get it on.
If I was going to be really fancy, I would remove the seeds. But I'm going to be lazy instead. Coat it well, though. Yep. Now, this just has to reduce, and it caramelizes. So do you remember anything else about the Food Network?
Remember the cookie making show where we made the gingerbread cookies, I think they were,
yes.
And we got to design them. And that was a lot of fun. I was able to get creative and artsy even though I was not. So it was
good. Do you remember what you did?
I think I made probably James Bond or something like that. I was quite obsessed with Mr. Bond when I was younger.
I remember one Halloween he was James Blonde.
Thanks, Ma. That's always good. Let the world know.
Okay, so see what we're doing? We're getting this nice color on here.
Wow, that looks great.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I'm going to get it off because it's smoking. Anytime things start smoking that much.
Yeah, you got to give it
some. We want this kind of color on the lemons, but we don't want a burnt pan.
No.
Okay, I'm just going to get this guy over.
Okay. Running away from me, Ma.
And let me get my spatula. We're just about ready to finish this.
Yeah, that looks great.
Now, here's the great thing about sautés, like this kind of dish or the pork dish we did a minute ago. Is that they take no time at all.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so these are gonna, I'm just gonna put them on top of the chicken.
Yeah, that looks good. Here, I'll help you.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that pretty? And this also gets sort of an A+ in visuals, I'd say.
Definitely does.
Whatever you do, don't touch that, because it's caramel. All right. Okay, watch out. Here goes. Stand back.
Whip-a!
Okay.
There you go, and I'll use this to get the rest of the little brown bits up.
Yes, do that, please. Now, when you make this recipe, you should follow the recipe where you do the lemons first and then the shallots. But as we say, there's very little you can't fix when you're cooking, so you never apologize, never explain. We're going to bring this up to a boil.
Is that a Juliaism or your mom?
That's a Juliaism.
Okay.
Never apologize, never explain.
There we go, that sounds
good. So if it's a souffle and it falls, you just say it's a pudding cake.
Woo.
Right.
It's all about the phrasing of it all.
It's the phrasing, it's the positioning, right? Because everybody's so happy you cooked and they didn't. Okay, I think we can put everything in. Gently slide in the chicken and I'll put in the shallots. You spread it around. You know the routine.
Get all the deliciousness on.
Yeah, and you keep turning it. I'm going to get some butter. Okay, so let's put a few tablespoons
here,
in.
Yeah, yeah, give you some room to plop them in.
Just let it. It's pretty darn good, doesn't it?
Yeah, I'm getting quite
hungry.
We're
just letting the chicken finish cooking a little bit in the sauce. Basically, it was done to begin with, right, Sammy?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's set ourselves up. Are you hungry?
So hungry. And you've eaten the broccoli and the quinoa too, right?
Yes.
All right. Thank you, ma'am.
Let's see.
There we go.
Yum, yum. We're gonna go sit outside.
Sounds good.
A little more sauce, right? It's all about
more
the sauce.
All about the sauce.
We eat the lemons too, isn't that fun?
Yeah, it's great.
All right, so I'm just gonna set up another plate and I'll meet you outside.
Sounds good, Matt.
All right. All right, another great meal cooked by the Sammy Mommy team.
Squad.
Thank you so much. So I'm interested if this beats your pork dish. You have to tell me. And you have to take a little bite of the lemon too. And the caper. I know normally you're not a big fan of capers.
Hey, anything you make, you know I'm gonna have a taste.
Mm, mm, mm. All right. Boy, that's awfully good if I do say so myself. Wow. Thank you so much for joining me today. And Sammy, thank you for cooking with me.
Mm.
I hope you try these quick, simple sautés at home. They're just the best. I'm Sara Moulton. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you next time for some more of Sara's Weeknight Meals. What do you think?
Winning. I like the lemon, I like the capers.
Not too chewy.
And I know this is a huge surprise. Love the sauce.
Oh, we could even have more, right? We should make double sauce.
More sauce, better sauce.
More sauce. I think always more sauce. So do you remember the recipe that you invented on the Food Network?
Oh, no? What
was it? Well, remember you had this brilliant idea for chocolate pizza?
I remember I had an idea for a pizza with chocolate chips on it. I didn't have an idea.
For chocolate pizza. Well, at any rate, I thought that was right up there with the meatball joke. I thought, you know, oh, my son at 5, he's so smart. Wow.
Sara's Weeknight Meals continues online. For recipes, helpful tips, messages, and lots more, visit us on the web at saramoulton.com/weeknightmeals. And go to our YouTube channel, Sara's Weeknight Meals TV. Funding provided by
the 2016 Subaru Legacy. With symmetrical all-wheel drive plus 36 mpg. It pairs well with every kind of road. Subaru, proud sponsor of Sara's Weeknight Meals.
And thanks to the generous support of